Okay, it's spring. Time for me to give you an update on how my experiment went growing tropical fruit trees here in the very not tropical Northern California Zone 9B. How do they do? Well, I'll talk more about what went on this winter, but first let me just cut right to the chase. I'm going to break this into three categories for you, okay? Trees that thrived, and there were definitely some trees that thrived all winter, trees that were damaged but survived, and trees that died, okay? All right, so I wrote this down on my phone so I don't forget. Otherwise, there's a lot of stuff. I'll forget some, but... So what thrived? All right. Longan, starfruit, jabodicaba, cabeluda, Suriname cherry, cherry of the Rio Grande, allspice, cherimoya, atamoya, and lucuma did great. And we'll walk through the trees. I'll show you soon. But what was damaged but didn't quite didn't die? Cinnamon, Drumichama, Cedar Bay cherry, and some of the mangoes, okay? Now what died, or mostly died? Now, unfortunately, this is the largest category. Lychee, green sapote, achachiru, Lux garcinia, imbe, black sapote, peanut butter fruit, patomba, cinnamon apple, wax jambu, bay rum, and some of the other mangoes. And I actually lost one cherimoya and longan too, in addition to the ones that did much better, so. I know that's a lot of dead plants, but that was all part of the plan. That was what I knew was going to happen, and it wasn't a loss because, as you'll see in a minute, some of these experiments worked out great. So what happened this winter? Well, it wasn't the coldest winter we've ever had, but as anyone living in California knows, it was a wet winter. We got more than double of our annual or average rainfall historically. So the soil was constantly cold and wet. And frost is one thing, but cold, wet soil is really bad for these trees. They're not used to that, and it causes the roots to rot. And even a small bit of frost damage can be fatal because the trees are sick and their roots aren't healthy, and it just is a slippery slope. So that wasn't good, but the other thing is, I said in my video that I was gonna protect the trees, put covers on them and Christmas lights, but I actually decided not to do that. And the reason is I wanted to learn what trees I can grow here that are as easy to grow as citrus, avocados, apples, peaches, all the stuff. I don't wanna sign up for a lifestyle, and I don't want you to sign up for a lifestyle in the wintertime of freaking out every time it gets cold and running out and putting blankets on and taking them off and hooking up Christmas tree lights. That's not the type of gardening I wanna do. So I didn't do it. And I'm glad I didn't do it because, you know, I learned that many of these trees don't need it. And I wouldn't know if they need it or not if I had done it all winter. So why don't we go and take a walk through the orchard, and I'll show you first the stuff that did really well. This beautiful happy tree you're looking at is the Kohala longan, and it did great. It's still green, it's beginning to grow again, and it had very, very minor damage. There were a few leaves on top that had actual ice, like hard frost on them, and those fell off, but the rest of the tree didn't seem to mind the cold at all. And I think this stands a chance of actually growing into a happy, healthy tree and bearing fruit very soon. Right next to it, let me just pan the camera over. If you could see that, that right there is another longan tree. That is BuQ. And it's dead. It's kind of hard to see it because it dried up and died. And so what this tells us is BuQ has no cold tolerance, and Kohala does. And actually that wasn't a total surprise to me because that's what people online were telling me. But I didn't actually know if Kohala had enough cold tolerance to make it here. Here's one of the bigger surprises to me. I've heard so many accounts of people in Northern California failing to get a starfruit through the winter. But this starfruit tree here did great. It didn't mind at all when we had frost, and it held all of its leaves. They're still nice and green. Okay, maybe not all its leaves. There definitely was a small amount of leaf drop. I'm gonna say maybe a third of the leaves fell off, and there's a little bit of frost damage on the tips. Let me see if I can pan around and show you. See, that's one of the tips right there. that actually did get a little frost damage, blackened up, and I'll just snip those off. It's a small percentage of the overall tree. And the variety here, and this is what I think is the big difference maker. This is a dwarf heart. I got it from Top Tropicals. I had no idea whether it was more or less cold tolerant than others, but turns out it is. This may be the difference, just like with the longan, getting the Kohala just happens to be the one that's well adapted to our winters, and dwarf heart turns out to be, at least this dwarf heart, pretty cold tolerant. Okay, let's talk about jabodicabas. I actually have five different species of jabodicabas, because there are many, and I'm going to make a video about this in the future. Many, many different species and named cultivars of jabodicaba. So they all did great. They all survived. And the one you're looking at right now is a species called Coronata. And it's covered in beautiful new leaves, red, shiny, glossy, gorgeous. The whole tree is. And it didn't blink even a little bit at winter. And neither did the one behind it, which is Plinia truncaflora. Same deal, no complaints at all about the frost, and it's already regrowing nicely, full of new leaves for spring. This one here is the red jabodicaba, or hybrid, or precocious, as it's sometimes called. This one's not quite as eager to get going now that it's spring. It's barely starting to grow, and that's okay because it didn't really mind the winter either. These trees normally do drop all of their leaves. That's a normal behavior for them, not a big deal. And it did drop most of its leaves. Maybe not most, maybe like half. Finally, this here is, or should I say was, the common jabodicaba known as Sabra. And you're thinking, oh no, it's dead. No, actually, because it's so common, I decided to convert it to a different, more rare, and better tasting variety called Grimmel. So I actually pruned off most of the tree and then grafted on those sticks of Grimmel, which if you look closely, you can see the parafilm at the end. And I already had a Grimmel, a very small one. I'll show you right over here. Yeah, that little guy right there is, not that, that right there is a small Grimmel I planted last year, and it didn't mind the winter. Again, it is a little scrawny because it dropped most of its leaves, but just like the others, it's growing back. But now I'm going to try to fast forward, save a little time, and graft Grimmel onto my larger tree. Another huge surprise here, allspice. I had zero clue that allspice was so hardy, but probably this one gets the award for most cold tolerant, because not only did it not sustain any damage, it actually held onto most of its newest, most tender leaves. And that's usually the first thing to go in a cold. And you can see that little sprig of brand new growth coming up now. Allspice, super ideal for Bay Area climates. All right, let's talk about cherimoyas and atamoyas. This guy right here is El Bumpo. And no problem at all with the cold. In fact, it's doing they're doing their normal thing right now, all the cherimoyas, where they drop their leaves and then they immediately start growing again. This one's about halfway through with the leaf drop. And I also have a booth cherimoya, which has been here now for 2 years and has had no problems. Now, I did lose a cherimoya, surprisingly. I had one that had also been here 2 years called Pierce, which was always kind of a sickly tree, never really got going, and just straight up died. I don't know if Pierce is that cold sensitive, or I just had an unhealthy tree. Something to be aware of, though. Pierce. Now, let's talk about atamoyas, okay? So, I have one atamoya. I actually thought it was a sugar apple. I called it a sugar apple in my video from last year. Turns out it is an atamoya, and appears to be just as cold tolerant as cherimoya. Okay, here's Lucuma, looking great. The only thing that I noticed was this very upper twig here got blasted a little bit, died back, but you know, here's another one. That's it. That's all the damage on this whole tree. And it's got some new leaves coming up, looking good. I feel pretty good about growing Lucuma here in the Bay Area now. Okay, this tree doesn't look so good, but don't worry. This is the Cabaluda, or yellow jabodicaba, and it's fine. It just dropped all of its leaves, and that's just normal behavior for these trees. in response to the cold, and it's already beginning to grow back. There's new leaves popping out of it, so not too worried about this tree. This is the Suriname cherry. This isn't really a big surprise because over in Prush Park in San Jose, they've got some big, very old Suriname cherries that fruit a lot. What's surprising is that you don't see this in nurseries around the Bay Area. There should be more people selling it commercially because it's super cold tolerant, great tree for the Bay Area, and I've got three different types here. They drop their leaves, not a big deal, grow them right back, and it's already covered, looks great. Okay, cherry of the Rio Grande, same exact deal as Suriname cherry, okay? Everyone in the Bay Area should at least consider growing this. Delicious fruit, no problem at all with the winter, perfectly adapted to the Bay Area. Grow a cherry of the Rio Grande, if you can find one. Unfortunately, just like Suriname cherry, you're not gonna find it at any of our local nurseries. All right, let's talk about trees that got a little bit of damage. Cinnamon right here, okay? It doesn't look too bad, right? It's green, it's alive, but what happened was there was a week in mid-February, okay? Prior to that, all winter, through many frosts, this tree looked great. Not a single indication that it wasn't happy. Beautiful and green. But then all of a sudden, and this happened to a couple other trees we'll talk about, in mid-February, all this outer growth turned black, the leaves shriveled up like this, dropped off, and, you know, I'd say a third of the tree basically must have had delayed cold damage. It's interesting that it took it a month or two to actually show up. Just goes to show you, you walk out, you know, a day or two after a frost and everything looks fine. It may not be fine. Now, my formula for whether or not a tree gets a passing grade and gets to live here long term after you see stuff like this happen is the damage greater than the previous year's growth? Now, the good news about cinnamon here is that the new growth from last summer started around here. This is where the height of the tree when I got it, okay? And so about half of that new growth got damaged. The wood was too tender, it wasn't hardened up yet. So that's okay, it passes. It has a net positive. So cinnamon gets to stay, and I hope as it gets bigger, you'll see every year a little bit of damage to the tips, but the tree will get bigger and bigger and it'll be able to keep going, no problem. I'll just prune off the damage every year. Maybe even some point the whole tree will be so strong it won't happen at all. I don't know, but cinnamon gets to stick around here another year. Okay, here's the Grumichama, or Brazilian cherry people call it. Same story as with cinnamon. Looked great, not a hint of unhappiness all winter. Mid-February, boom. Huge amount of damage shows up delayed. Not quite as high of a ratio of living to dead as the cinnamon, but I'm gonna keep it another year and see what happens. A lot of dead stuff to prune off here, unfortunately. But look at this beautiful new growth coming up here. How could you take out something that pretty? Here's a strange one. This is Cedar Bay cherry, relative of the Grumichama from Australia. And it doesn't look great. What happened is as soon as the temps got below 40, all these leaves, which used to be green, turned red and yellow and got all these black spots. And the same thing happened to some of my other Eugenias we'll talk about later. But what was different about this one is it actually held on to the leaves. They didn't shrivel up and die and drop off. If I take one of these leaves off, what you would see is there's a little bit of green at the base, which shows the wood is alive, the tree is alive. It just couldn't hold on to its leaves. So this may or may not be able to bounce back. I don't know yet. Jury is out, but fingers crossed. Okay, let's talk about mangoes. Overall, not too happy with my mangoes, but they're not all dead. I've got four, and one of the four is definitely completely dead. The other three have varying amounts of life in them. One of them has not a single leaf on it, but there's new green little nubs starting to come out of the bark, so it's trying to grow back. Two of the others have leaves on them, but not a lot. And I really don't know whether I should dig them out. I probably will leave at least two of them in another year, see what happens, but Overall, I would say that I am just the latest of many Bay Area growers to fail to get a mango through the winter. They really aren't happy here, and there's maybe some magical circumstances, you know, close to a house, south facing, blah, 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 where you can get a mango to survive here. But out here in the open, in the middle of my backyard, is not that place. So, sorry, mangoes. As for the rest of the trees, well, they all pretty much look like this here peanut butter fruit. Just kind of dead sticks coming out of the ground. Now, there might be some life in them. I bet a few of them, if I left them in, would start to sprout up a little from the roots. But I'm going to take them out because I've got other things I'd rather plant here. So that's okay. That was bound to happen. And, if I hadn't done this, I might not have known I could get a longan or a star fruit or allspice or lucuma or any of those trees through the winter looking so good. Not just surviving, like, you know, the Gumichama here, barely surviving, but actually, you know, looking as good as any citrus or avocado tree. So I consider this a success. And I hope if you're a Bay Area gardener and you're watching, you'll try to get a lucuma or an allspice tree or any of the other trees I showed good results from here. That would be awesome. So thanks for watching and happy gardening.